So the potential for the earthquake to happen again is very real, but we don't know when. Could be tomorrow, could be hundreds of years in the future. And we have to be prepared for that possibility. The earthquakes, in a way, are what makes this a beautiful region to live in, right? The landscape of the Pacific Northwest happens because of the plate tectonics, and manifestation of that is the earthquakes themselves. So enjoy it, you know, live here, take advantage of what it has to offer, but be prepared at the sort of personal level to be ready for some kind of disaster or emergency event. People will start to be able to feel earthquakes, and it depends on the conditions locally, when they're around magnitude 3-something, you know, or so. That's like the fault. It's like two plates of the rock are pressed together deep in the earth. And they just stick and stick and stick, and then one day they go, you know, and slip, and that's the earthquake. When an earthquake takes place, people have this idea, and it's sort of the Hollywood movie version of just massive devastation of absolutely everything. And every place I've ever seen where a big earthquake has occurred, really it's very patchy, you know. The vast majority of people will be fine, even in a big event. One of the challenges for us in terms of keeping people in the Pacific Northwest aware of the potential for earthquakes or even what they're all about is that we don't experience them very often. People living in Los Angeles or San Francisco, you know, will feel an earthquake occasionally. You know, every year or two there's something pretty big that people might feel. But we go many, many years around here sometimes between noticeable earthquakes. So we're trying to keep that in the public eye. We're detecting them all the time, and we're aware of what's going on and making sure that if something is of concern, that people hear about it.